So we're gonna do something a little different tonight, being a private show and all. We're gonna try something that we've recently been doing. I think it's gonna work on most y'all. First of all, I don't think many people here are from Vegas, so on the count of three, shout out where you're from. One, two, three. All right. Yeah, that's what I thought. So, Vegas. Well, technically Hendersonville, but you know, Vegas. Henderson. Palm Beach. Oh, Miami Beach. All right, man. Love Miami Beach. I got family lives right in Miami Beach. All right, stay warm. We've been a band for 16 years, but for like 18, 19 years, I've been writing songs, way too many songs, but some of them turn into big hits for other artists, ranging from Paul McCartney to Taylor Swift, from Ed Sheeran to Maroon 5, Lil Nas X to Miley Cyrus. And so, you know, most of you, if you came here, you know, most of you know who we are. There's a handful of you who are a little confused. We're about four songs in, and you've already Googled One Direction, and you looked at the photo, you thought, well, you know, it's Berkshire. I know they can afford it. So, you look at the photo, you go, that's not One Direction. These guys are way more handsome. Who are these guys? Who are these? Who are these guys? But fair enough. People of a certain age, One Direction, One Republic, we've been around a lot longer. So, here's the thing, and I just keep it simple. For those of you who are not initiated, raise your hand if you've ever shopped in a Whole Foods or organic grocery store. Raise your hand if you've ever flown on an airline. You have heard our music. You've heard a lot of it. So, we're gonna rip through those tonight, but here's what I'm gonna do in the next 15 minutes. If my voice can keep up, and I'm going to go ahead and I've never done this in 16 years, I've never said this in a concert. I'm going to ask forgiveness ahead of time because my voice is halfway through every song, my voice is trying to give out on me, which I'm just going to punch through it. I'm going to punch through it. Remember, you can't say no. So, it's a good thing Las Vegas has a lot of humidity. The next 15 minutes, what we're going to do is this. I'm gonna say six or seven songs that went number one that I wrote for other artists. We're gonna do them in a medley. Okay? So that way, One Republic fan, casual fan, assertive fan, you know, backseat driver, I'm gonna hit you with something tonight where you're gonna go, okay, I get it. The first one I'm gonna need help on, because what's weird is my voice is fine here, my voice is, whee! But where most of the songs I sing sit is right here, and that's where my voice is giving out tonight. So some of these notes, these are songs y'all are gonna know. So this is gonna be a big karaoke Vegas moment. Here we go. Here we go. Home Services, let's go. Come on, we're gonna send it. All right. I've written quite a few songs for Beyonce. This is the first one I ever wrote. It goes like this. Take the jacket off then. It goes like this. I found a way to let you in, but I never really had it down. Standing in the light of halo, got my angel out. It's like a bit of waiting. If you pull out, you break it. It's the risk that I'm taking. I ain't never gonna shut you out. see ya. I can feel ya, halo, 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 I feel ya. For just a minute, okay? So this next song, just do a chorus of it. I did it with my man Brent Cutzel on cello back here. We wrote this together. And there's a fabulous artist from London. Actually, she's not from London, but she talks like this. Ellie Goulding. Ellie Goulding, anybody? She put it out. She's incredible. Song goes like this. Jump back across the pond. this is like an Uber driver's playlist slash Whole Foods, slash Whole Foods. Really, every one of these songs plays at Whole Foods. I don't know what it is about Whole Foods, but thank you, Whole Foods. Do we have any Adele fans in here? Oh shit. Okay. So done a bunch of songs. I don't know. I'm a bit of an there it is. Heard that. I'm a bit of an Anglophile. Most of my influences are other than like the Beach Boys and some gospel artists. Most of my influences are British, and so I ended up working with a lot of British artists. And Adele was one of them. So when she put out Chasing Pavements, I thought, I need to work with that chick. She's crazy. We connected. We did a few songs on an album called 21. And then we did some now songs on 25. The first song we did is about turning tables. The second song we did is this next one we're about to do. She walked in. The album 21 is about one dude, one relationship that went really south, was really bad. This dude sucks. I don't know his name, but he's terrible, apparently. And 40 million albums later, he's really bad. So she came in, was playing me all this music, had this like southern gospel, like deep south kind of thing, Mississippi, Alabama, Tennessee, and I was like, oh, I love this, I'm down with this, I get it. Excuse me. And I started stomping on the floor. She walked in, she's like, I'm not in the mood to do a song today, Your Honor. I'm not in the mood. I'm sorry that I'm here. We booked the studio, but I'm not in the mood. I said, all right, what's the problem? She said, well, do you know, I'll tell you what the problem is. I had a conversation with my friends this weekend. They're saying, Adele, rumor has it, you've been hooking up with this person. Rumor has it that you've been talking with this person. Rumor has it that you're an alcoholic. Rumor has it that you've done this, you've done that, you do this. She kept saying, rumor has it, rumor has it, rumor has it. And so I said, okay, we don't have to do a song today. But if we did, I think we should do Rumor Has It. She was like, that's not that. Like. She literally paused for a second and looked up at the sky. I was like, oh, that's nice. And I said, she goes, well, what does it sound like? I said, well, I don't want to do any more ballads. She just played me Someone Like You. Imagine someone playing you Someone Like You and being like, what should we write today? So I was like, okay, I don't want to do a ballad. Let's do a tempo. I started stomping. I started playing this riff on the piano. I was playing on guitar. Da, 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 da. And she goes, what's the melody? I go, she ain't real. She ain't gonna be able to love you like I will. She is a stranger. You and my eyes will be hooked. Don't you remember? Sure, she's got it all. But baby, is that baby what you let's go. Okay. She's playing next weekend, y'all. Y'all go see that shit. She'll do turning tables as well, I promise. Really? And Hello, which I'm not even going to try to sing right now. Alright, so we'll do the opposite of Adele, but the one thing they have in common, they're about to do a Vegas residency that starts this week. So I've done a bunch of songs with and for Maroon 5, some of them are hits. Any Maroon 5 fans can have it. I tell you, I don't care what you're a fan of, I'm going to find out. Read the credits. Ozzy Osbourne? Yeah! Alright. I did his last album as well, so we don't have time for that. Thomas Rhett? You guys okay? Keep going. Ain't nothing but a beer can fix, man. I'll do a couple more Room 5 things that you might know, and we'll move on, okay? My voice will keep up with me. Come on. Can I get some more of the hot tea? So here's one of the records I did. It goes like this. It's called Maps. Medley. I miss the distance we like. I miss the conversation. I feel like I'm doing promo for Maroon 5's residency right now. This is weird, but I'm gonna keep it. One more, then we'll move on. I love this song. Originally when we did this, I was listening to a bunch of Robin. Like two Robin fans in the game. But anyway, we ended up with this song. I texted it to Adam. I had the verse and the melody and the lyric, he said, I have a chorus melody idea for this. Adam's a really good writer, and when he wants to sit down and write, he's great. And this is what ended up being one of their hits. It goes like this. I said 7 or 8 number ones. These are all number ones, so I'm going to keep number ones. The next two records both hit number one in the U.S. radio, and then we're going to move right back into One Republic. Ain't no number two shit going on here. Come on now. Warren said number ones only. That's the email. I read the email, man. He said literally number two shit, and he put an X to it, and then did the emoji like, no. And I was like, God, man, go eat a burger. So the first time I met this artist, he came to my studio. He was 19 years old. It was on his birthday. And the day he turned 19, the first song he wrote He was sleeping on a couch in Atlanta selling Domino's pizza. And he found out on his birthday, the day he met me, that the first song he ever wrote hit number one on Billboard. Number one song in America, number one song in the world. And then it broke every record in Billboard history. It was number one for 19 weeks. He beat Mariah Carey and Boyz II Men, which makes no sense to me. But it happened. And people thought he was a one-hit wonder. And I didn't think he was. And we started working together, and then we ended up doing a bunch of songs. And we did this song right here. This is the number one most played song in the world last year. I want the last one on the concert. Within the concert, I'm gonna bring it right back with a little Top Gun for you. So we got a bunch more. So